Now to nostalgic food news, and Aussie culinary icon Sizzler reopened its doors for one night only this week after it tragically shut up shop 4 years ago. I'm not sure I've stopped crying. For those lucky enough to secure tickets to the pop-up in Brisbane, there was soft serve, potato skins and the famous cheesy toast. Here to tell us all about it, one night in heaven, is Sizzler-savant and oracle of everything. It's Mel Buttle. What an honour to attend such a special night. Is it fair to say that you know your way around a Sizzler?
100%. Did you know? Let's have some Sizzler facts.
Yeah.
Yes.
The first Sizzler in Australia was actually opened in Brisbane, and very rightly so, because Queensland is no cuisine, or cuisine, as my mum would say. See, up here in Queensland, we don't ask if pineapple belongs on a pizza. We ask if a pizza belongs on a pineapple.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
How did you score a table at this exclusive event?
Mm. Okay, so some people, they get invited to the Logies, not this winner. I get invited to events where the food is served in vats. I had an amazing dinner of soft serve, then potato skins, then soup, then soft serve, then Caesar salad, then apple crumble, then bolognese, then potato bake.
Yeah.
I walked out of there like I used to in the old days with the top button of my pants undone because I went hard.
Mel, being back in a Sizzler, it must have felt... Did it feel like a spiritual experience almost? What did you learn on this quest?
Well, Mr. Media,
thank you.
Thank you for the question. I'm worried. I'm worried we're losing important parts of our suburban history because Sizzler's gone, OK? We cannot lose hog's breath, all right? I had some issues, actually, today. It's a bit weird to tell you guys this. I was trying to book an Ansett flight. It just wouldn't work. So if we lose that great airline, I'll be so upset. I'll have to go to Brash's and buy a Peter Andre CD to cheer myself up.
Yeah. But Mel, what was it like being surrounded by the upper echelon of the Australian food industry?
I was elbow deep with them, Waleed. Yeah. We were all at the trough together. It was amazing. There was a Brisbane Bronco player there, which was very exciting for me.
That is exciting.
It was Corey Oates. And
we love Corey.
He's so hot. He had a huge bowl of ice cream. He was eating this massive bowl of ice cream. And I was like, well, no wonder we're 13th on the ladder, mate. But this is a pop-up. It was honestly better than my wedding. I got a free hat. What did I get at my wedding? A huge bill and jawline Ackley from the stress.
Well, Mel, it's such a great time. When do you think it all started to go downhill for Sizzler?
It is when Jamie Oliver and his little celebrity chef mates turned up with their prosciutto and their buffalo mozzarella and all of a sudden Sizzler wasn't good enough anymore, was it? Huh? We all wanted to go to restaurants where the waiter tells you a little story about where the carrots come from and who the chicken's mummy was. I don't want to have to go on a cruise to enjoy a buffet, OK? Bring back Sizzler. I should be able to behave in a manner at the dessert bar that puts me in a high-risk category for developing type 2 diabetes on dry land.
Cannot argue. Cannot argue, Mel. Thank you very much for your wisdom.
Thank you. Thank you, Robin.
It's honestly the greatest thing.